Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Today we are going to talk about the Ayurvedic and herbal medicines for diabetes. Yes, diabetes can be managed with herbal medicines, with Ayurvedic medicine, but you need to understand some basics about them. Today we are going to talk about the top 10 Ayurvedic herbal medicine substances which act against diabetes. So let's not waste any more time and let's start. Right, number one is Jamuna. Jamun is basically a fruit, and the fruit and the seed both are very effective against diabetes. It contains some substances called jambulin, and it is used for alternative healing purpose, healing systems like Ayurvedic, Chinese, Yunani medicines that's used there. The extract of this fruit as well as the seed both are effective in diabetes, in hyperglycemia, especially has been proven in diabetic rats as well. The fruit is also used for wine and vinegar preparation, as well as it is very high in vitamin A and vitamin C, right? The second thing which can be used for diabetes is berberis lycium. Berberis is very popular in wide variety of health issues. It is its root produces high concentrations of berberine, which is also used in traditional medicines. The whole extract of this plant is very useful or widely used to treat diabetes. In Ayurveda, it has been reported that this medicine is also a diaphoretic and a diuretic, which is used as a tonic as well as in various preparations for treating, you know, eye diseases, jaundice, skin, diarrhea, syphilis, chronic diseases, etc., rheumatoid diseases and urinary disorders as well, right? So the pharmacology and properties of this particular plant is also very deeply studied. Then third is Gudmar. Gudmar is one of the most primary active component, and its active component is also called as gymnamic acid, which actually helps suppress the sweetness of your tongue, right? Sweet feeling. It basically contains substances that decrease the absorption of sugar from your intestine, and it might also increase the amount of insulin in your body and increase the growth of cells in the pancreas, right? That it has been postulated, right? And this research has also shown that it can reduce the ability to taste sweetness in your body, so that sweet food will become less appealing. So that's why it is basically called as destroyer of sugars, right? Because of its effect on the taste buds. So that is Gudmar. Then there is something Karela, right? Karela, which is very, very commonly eaten in India, and it has a number of supported uses, including cancer prevention, diabetes, fever, HIV, AIDS, infections. It's active against all these things. And while it has shown very good potential in clinical activity in laboratory experiments, but further studies is basically going on this particular thing. But it is basically very well known for its usefulness in diabetes as well as sugar control, right? Then there is turmeric, haldi. So haldi is a basic ingredient which is present in all families in India. Mostly it's a plant from the ginger family, and it is basically also active ingredient of traditional Chinese Ayurvedic herbal medicines. Its active compound is curcumin. It has caught attention in recent times for a potential of treating various diseases. It's a good antioxidant, increases glutathione, has some activity against diabetes also. It's basically, the best part is it's relatively safe and very inexpensive. So it also can be used to, you know, boost your immunity. Turmeric milk is very routinely used in India, so you can also use that. Then prevention of diseases is also one of the good thing which happens if you take turmeric. Then the next thing is Vijayasar. Vijayasar is a wood. The heartwood of Vijayasar has antibiotic and hypoglycemic properties, and it's also used in diabetes. right? Then there is something called a skeno gum, which is obtained from the incision in the bark of this wood, has astringent and anti-diarrheal as well as anti-hemorrhagic properties. So anti-hemorrhagic, anti-diarrheal means it can be used in diarrhea, it can be used in blood problems, right? Leaves can also be used to treat external boils, sores and other skin diseases, while the flower, I know flowers are also used in certain medical purposes, right? So Vijayasar is good. Then there is neem is believed to be the core, you know, ingredient of Siddha, and many Ayurvedic practitioners, it is thought to be anti-helminthic, anti-fungal, anti-diabetes, antibacterial, antiviral, antiseptic, contraceptive, and also sedative, right? It is a major component of these alternative medicines, used very, very routinely for skin diseases, and it is also known for its effect against diabetes. It also seen to improve liver function and also detoxify blood at certain extent. But quite frankly, as it is very routinely used for skin diseases, eczema, psoriasis, etc., etc. So this is one ingredient, neem, which is also very good. Then there is Shilajit. Shilajit has something called as fulvic acid. Fulvic acid is a yellow-brown substance found in natural minerals. This is the main ingredient of it, right? Fulvic acid might have various effects on the body, and fulvic acid might actually block the reaction of the body that causes allergic symptoms. It might also interrupt steps involved in the worsening of brain disorders such as dementia. Additionally, these fulvic acid might reduce inflammation and or prevent or slow the growth of cancers. Can also prevent it. So fulvic acid actually is useful for stimulating your immune system. It has antioxidant effect. That's why Shilajit is used in India. The only problem is its purity, right? In invest, that's a major concern, right? Getting pure Shilajit. Then there is something known as Trigonella, fenugreek methi. Basically, seeds are very useful to reduce insulin resistance. Diabetes patients use them very often. Clinical trials with fenugreek seeds extract have suggested that if you take fenugreek, like 1 gram of the seed extract, then you can significantly reduce your blood glucose level within a few months. Then that is a good option to be included. And the last one, the top 10 last, is a bitter gourd. Bitter gourd is basically also having anti-diabetic properties. It is bitter, and mostly it is also used extensively in Ayurvedic medicine in diabetes. It helps to increase insulin secretion, improving the function of the pancreas, the beta health cells of the pancreas, and thereby somehow the diabetes becomes well controlled. So now you know about the top 10 ingredients, top 10 Ayurvedic herbal naturally occurring substances which are used in treatment of diabetes. But should you actually stop using your own allopathic medicines and start these? No, you should not do them. If your medicines, if your diabetes is not controlled and you want to try an additional medication, these ingredients are very good to add. And if you want to start off your treatment, then also you can go on these naturally occurring ingredients. But do not stop your allopathic medicines, do not stop your insulin, right, just by switching on to Ayurvedic medicines without monitoring your sugar. That is wrong. So what you need to do, you need to start monitoring your fasting blood sugar daily and start taking your medicines, allopathic medicines, with these naturally occurring ingredients, and see when your sugar comes down, then slowly with the discussions with your doctor, reduce your allopathic medicines, and then you can go on to your Ayurvedic treatment completely over a period of time. When your sugars become controlled and below 100, fasting sugar is below 100, below 80, then you should slowly stop your medicine. So that's how you use Ayurvedic medicines in diabetes. Do not stop your allopathic medicines or insulin just by switching on to these medicines. Now if you really want me to suggest a medicines, I would be suggesting the medicine from N Veda. N Veda has a medicine called SMB, Sugar Management and Balance Capsule. These are again very well certified, 100% good quality natural herbs, and they have 8 of these naturally occurring ingredients for your diabetes control. It has jamuna, it has the berberis, it has gudmar, karela, it has the turmeric, it has vijayasar, then neem or shuddh shilajit also. So all these things are present in this capsule, and you can start taking these capsules depending upon your diabetes. If it is very uncontrolled, you can take them 2 to 3 times a day, one tablet. And if it is good controlled and you just want to switch, then start taking one capsule per day and slowly increase the dose with discussions with your doctor. Obviously, you should have a doctor, general practitioner, endocrinologist, a diabetes doctor, or an Ayurvedic doctor with regular consultation, so that your sugars are under control. The main objective is the sugar level should not go very high for a long period of time, and it should not go very low also. Both are dangerous. Remember, if you really want to understand diabetes in further details, you can watch my other videos for diabetes. For this particular video, this section has been partnered with Enveda. I will also give you the link of that capsules in the description below. You can go and buy those capsules and let us know how well was your diabetes control. And if somebody wants to consult me online, the details have been given above and below in Hindi and English. You can contact us for needful. Thank you so much for watching. This is Dr. Paramjeet. Stay connected, stay healthy.